stadiums to me are just such special places, whether it's a small ground, big ground, junior ground. I'm a football tour guide, informing and entertaining the public about Glasgow's unique football history and culture. Glasgow is at the very beginning of the modern game, from hosting the first ever international game to breaking some all-time attendance records. In 1937, Scotland versus England, were just shy of 150,000 people in the ground that night, of course, standing for the most part. And 7 days later, you've got Celtic versus Aberdeen, the Scottish Cup final, and there's 146,000 people in the stadium. So within 7 days, you've got just shy of 300,000 folk just in Glasgow and Hampden Park. That's where I get my kick, that's where I get my buzz. Folks jaw-dropping when they realise how vital this city is to football. To me, the stadium encompasses what the city is about. It's a shared space, it's a shared memory, and it tends to be a positive space. It's one that you want to be in, it's one that you enjoy. Every time I go to a stadium, I'm kind of going story searching. Caffin Park's obviously the home of Third Lanark. It's actually the second Hampden Park as well, so it's our national stadium. The club have had success, they've won the Scottish Cup, they've won the league. But 1960s, a bad guy called Bill Huddleston gets involved in the club, purposely runs the football club into the ground to sell the land for housing. Club are no longer with us. They were, for want of a better word, I always say murdered. Now that land, of course, is still there. I often describe it as the graveyard of Glasgow's football scene. It must have been quite hard to see that happen and watch it before your eyes, seeing whole stands gone, trees grown out of places where you used to stand with your dad, your uncle, to watch your heroes. Sounds daft, but it doesn't really sound, it's quite whimsical, but it's like the colours and the smell and familiar faces and not so familiar faces. It's like an energy that exists. It's very, very special. Football's fun, man. It's there to be enjoyed. Whether the game is rank rotten or the best thing you've seen in the world. There's a story and there's a history being developed before your very eyes. If somebody was to come up and say to me that a stadium is just bricks and plastic seats, you're wrong.